2020, Dr. Francis Pescosolido.
Thank you. It's an honor to be here. It's an honor to receive this.
No, there's no mic, just put your...
That is my wife. So when she makes a comment, we all listen. It is really an honor to be here, having been here in East Greenwich from the age of 5. And I would like to thank Mr. Mastracchio, Mr. Hodling, for your support in this. And then I'd like to acknowledge my family, because we know that it takes a village. My wife, Deb DeSegna, Family Court Judges, I mentioned, for your kindness, your unconditional support, and your love. Thank you. To my son, Dr. Matthew Pescosolido, who's back there. And my daughter-in-law, who we are very, very fortunate to have in our lives, Dr. Catherine Pescosolido. Thank you. And the love and light of our lives, Luke Howard and Pescosolido. Yes, that's you. I would also like to thank my sister-in-law, Dr. Donna Merritt, for coming from out of state. Thank you. It means a great deal. And to our vivacious, my vivacious niece, Robin Merritt. Thank you. A dear colleague, Sharon Foley, who was a clinical social worker here for many years in the East Greenwich school system, and a valued colleague. Thank you. This award is truly deeply meaningful. It might sound trite and contrite. However, much of life that has meaning is, as I say to patients, as I talk when I lecture, it's the essence of life. Our connections, people that we love who have been there for us. And in this regard, I'll give you some of my history and context of East Greenwich and East Greenwich High School. I started at Hannaford School. Before that, I too was at Our Lady of Mercy, but my mother thought that I might be able to do a little better not being in the parochial school system. That was a pleasant and euphemism to say that I moved on and moved out. I went to Hannaford School. Then I went to the junior high school. Believe it or not, when I was here, was the top floor of Eldridge School. That was the top floor, and that was the junior high school. Very different from what exists today. I was at the high school, which was on Cedar Avenue, which was considered quite fancy for a long period of time. And then I graduated in 1968, which was the first graduating class. And one of the mantras that I remember from Rufus Brackley, who was then the principal, one of his announcements consistently was, "Please do not walk on the unborn grass." I cannot make that up, because it was what it was. I've been very fortunate having very, very deep and meaningful connections and friendships in East Greenwich. And as we know, and I won't get too clinical or theoretical, but we know that adolescence is a time when we form a sense of who we are, and both from being who our connections are, which is like a mirror psychologically. And I felt deeply cared about. I felt that I learned conviction and validation, and I had a lot of great fun. And where's Mr. Lynch, who was just speaking? I too was the iconic late bloomer. My wife is probably going to comment, like, why? almost didn't graduate. Well, that's a little exaggerated, but not too far. I had great fun and great, and I have great dear personal memories of being in East Greenwich with the relational glue, if I want to sound somewhat clinical, that there was a lot of connection, and that really gave me an internal sense of heartfeltness and a sense of being able to go forward. Some of my most heartfelt memories are not in academia, but in context of, for those of you that saw American Graffiti, the iconic phrase of the time was bombing around. And that meant, for those of you who knew of East Greenwich, it meant getting in your car on Friday and Saturday with a bunch of your friends, parking at Jolly John's, which is now, at the foot of the hill on Route 1, thank you. And we would go there and park and go from car to car. Then we would go through town, Main Street, and we'd drive past the Creamery to see who was there. We would then go to Two Guys Pizza, which was a mainstay, and often we stayed there quite late or until we were asked to leave. So what you're hearing from me is relational or connections that were really very, very deep and likely has had a profound impact on my profession and my focus on working in the human behavioral field, particularly in context of a sense of relatedness. It's probably why I continue, to my wife's dismay to this day, and this is the honest truth. We live in Narragansett now, but my son was fortunate to be in the East Greenwich school system, which was very important. But I continue to drive through Main Street, and I will point out consistently, this is where we did this, this is where Jolly John's was, this is what we did here, because it means a great deal to me. And when I just reviewed this with her before this evening, she said, well, you probably should say that you still drive around the neighborhoods too. Which I do. I mean, I do. When I was growing up, Frenchtown was, with all due respect to the affluence and those of you who live in Frenchtown, it was considered a farm country. And that's where we would go probably to not adhere to the rules. And how do I say this? Cars Pond, etc. So for me, I want to close by saying that you can go back home. And for me, being here and being home has always been deeply, deeply heartfelt for me. So I am deeply appreciative of this acknowledgement and honor. And I will continue, and I may see some of you as I continue to drive through Main Street.